Hi, my name is Daniela Bergschneider. I'm originally from Germany and I came to Norway 2 years ago to do my master in fine arts. I have a background in textile design. Before coming to Norway, I did a master in textile design in Hamburg. And since I came to Norway, also ceramics became an equally important part of my practice. I work with a phenomenon called visual tactility. So if you see my works, you can imagine how they feel, how they would behave if you would move them, if they are soft, if they are hard, if they are heavy or light. But as the viewers are not allowed to touch my pieces, this gap between the hand and the eye needs to be filled out with the viewer's own embodied experience with the material. With textile and ceramics, I use two materials that have a very long tradition in the history of humankind and that we all know very well from our everyday life. We have a very intimate relationship with these materials, but I transform them in a way that they seem alien to the viewer. I'm very interested in our human emotions and reactions. Through my works, I want to create ambiguous feelings in the viewer and to find an expression for the many contradictions in life. It's also about finding an expression for things that cannot be put into words, but that can be communicated in a visual way. I am especially interested in the ambiguity between attraction and repulsion. So I use beauty as a way to drag the viewer into the work, to seduce the viewers in order to shift this to the opposite, to the uncanny, the threatening, the monstrous, the disturbing. And I'm always creating shapes that are on one hand recognizable. You might associate it with something from the animal world, something that you might find inside your body, something that you might encounter under a microscope, but at the same time, the works always deny classification, so you can never really point on what it is exactly. For me, the textiles are like the skin of my sculptures, and the ceramics are like the bone or the teeth. And by combining these two different materials in one single sculpture, the qualities of each material are highlighted, and in this way the soft and the hard, the opaque and the transparent, the strong and the brittle are combined in one sculpture. What I find very interesting about ceramics in this work is that the shapes are very aggressive. They might seem threatening, but at the same time, you know that ceramics is a very fragile material and it breaks very easily. So these aggressive shapes are very vulnerable in reality. Material and process play a very important part in my practice. I like to say that I'm thinking through making, I'm thinking through material. So I never start with a fixed idea that I have created in my head, but I use the material as a starting point. And my studio is like a laboratory where I make different test series and material sketches. This can go for months before I finally decide on something. And when I encounter something that fascinates me and where I see the potential that it can grow further, I continue working on it and let it grow in size. And usually my works have kind of a size that is huggable, that relates to our body, like it's another organism that you are communicating with. My work consists of a multiplicity of elements inside one single artwork. I'm very interested in growth processes in nature and how the single element relates to the whole. And I have a static presentation, but I'm always searching for ways to create movement and that you can imagine that the work might continue growing, transforming, that its final state is not reached yet.